you very much, Honorable Mayisela. I call upon Honorable Carter.
Thank you, House Chairperson. It's a pity I cannot see the Minister. But will Scope supports the ideology and the morality behind the push for universal health care? The national health insurance model currently being pursued by the African National Congress's government is unaffordable and too dependent on high economic growth levels which we do not have or we will not have under this current administration. What is urgently required is a back-to-basic approach. In this regard, it is telling that the department spent 99.4% of its budget in 2015-16, but only achieved 64% of its budget. In getting back to basics, we need to ensure that our hospitals and vital equipment are repaired and maintained, ensure that more clinics are developed, especially in our impoverished communities, resolve our underspending in the primary healthcare programs, improve our governance and management systems, resolve the dysfunctionality of our nursing education system, and attend the development of our clinic workforce. We need to resolve the medical internship placement program problems faced and resolve the inhumane working hours that we expect from our doctors. A far worse and more heinous and immoral crisis exists within many of our provincial departments of health in respect of their findings or their failings and in many instances unacceptable and inhumane delivery and non-delivery of a basic and fundamental service. Gauteng faced the Isidimeni tragedy, but in KwaZulu-Natal, there's a critical shortage of doctors and massive vacancy with just two oncologists and two radiologists and two urologists serving the entire eThekwini region. Neonatal mortality has increased. A report regarding specialised TB hospital, St. Margaret's, said that all wards are non-compliant to the National Core Standard Infection Prevention and Control. This while KZN remains the epicentre for TB in the world. And then we don't even have N95 masks available. The province only has 129 functioning ambulances, despite them needing 1,057 for its population size. To make matters worse, they are being dilapidated, aging, and even being stolen. Broken radiotherapy machines and a crumbling oncology service continue while people are dying excruciating and untimely deaths. Unfortunately, I do not have sufficient time to deal with all the provinces, but Minister, I did send you a pile of emails with complaints from doctors what is actually happening in hospitals. Minister, COPE has asked you numerous questions during 2017, which all came from doctors in the government service. From within your hospitals, it is clear your department does not know what is happening in our hospitals, and they are not informing you of a true state of affairs. Please check those emails. I want to quote one of the Limpopo doctors who responded to your reply to the questions. His MECs, and I quote, his MECs and heads of departments are hiding information from him. If he doesn't descend from Mount Olympus and go visit these hospitals, he will continue living in a delusional state where all is well. I challenge him to visit only hospitals in Limpopo and then still confidently say there is the necessary equipment. Minister, I'm going to make these responses available, which I have. But we cannot support this budget
vote. Can you take a question?
And I call on you, Honourable Minister, to ensure that operational life-saving equipment are made available and that we refocus on getting the basics right. Thank you, Minister.
Thank you very much, Honourable Carter.